First of all, thank you very much for clicking on my video, and I hope you are having a great day. This is an auto layout button, and in the previous video, I have showed you how to make this button. If you want to watch it, please check the description. Trust me, it's life-saving. So in this video, I'm going to take this handy auto layout button and make it even handier. This video have two steps. First, I'll convert this button into a component, so that the button will be reusable. And the biggest advantage of the component button is if you change the mother button's design, the child button's design will be also changed, so that you do not have to change every single button in your whole design. In the second step, I'm going to convert this component into a variant so that you can have every options of the button in a form of toggle or drop downs. It's actually very easy to do and save lots of time in the process. Hi, this is ababir and welcome to my channel Design Thinking. Let's get into it. So let's start with the auto layout button, and before I convert it into a component, let's make a copy of it. Hide this icon, rename it to button. Now I'll rename this auto layout layer too. Let's call it button/no. Well, there's a reason to name it like this, but first let me make a copy of it. Click on it, hold Alt or Command and drag. Now here I will unhide an icon. I will change this no to yes. At this point, I have ensured two versions of this button. One is with an icon and another one is without an icon. Now I will also put the name of the icons on the layer. So another slash, and it's a save icon, so save. Nice. Okay, I want four more different icons in one button, so I'll make a copy of it and repeat the same. It might sound a bit confusing, but stay with me. Hide the previous icon, unhide the new one, and in this case, I will just change the name of the icon of the layer, and everything else will be the same. I'll go a bit faster here as I am repeating the same thing. All done, nice. Now I'll convert it into a component. Select it, right click on it. Now click here, it says create component. And that's it, it's a component now. Or you can use the keyboard shortcut to do it faster. Now all these are a component, and if we go to the asset tab, we'll find these buttons in here. You can just drag it into your design and use it, but that's not what we want. So let's make it even more easier to use. So go back to the layer tab, select all the components, and after selecting all components, you will see this button. It says combine as variant. Let's click on it. And now your button is a component variant. I'll just put some simple description here. This is the icon state, yes or no. And these are the name of the icons. Now that's it. To use it, drag it from the asset tab and put it anywhere in your design you want. I can add an icon using this toggle. I can also choose what icon we need from this dropdown. It's very handy, much simpler to use, and save lots and lots of time. I'll show you a few more practical examples of it in my future videos. By the way, this simple but gorgeous animation made using Figma, and I'll show you how to do it in my next video. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want more videos like this, please subscribe. Thanks a lot for watching, and I will see you in the next video.